Globally, youth unemployment is a major challenge governments are confronted with. In Nigeria, the situation appears much more worrisome as the unemployment rate is quite startling, and Delta States, being a part of the states in Nigeria, is not immune to this hydra-headed monster. To confront it head-on, Senator Dr. Arthur Ifeanyi-Okowa, on assumption of office in 2015, announced empowerment packages aimed at making young Deltans business owners, entrepreneurs, and employers of labor, rather than job seekers.
Job creation will be the cornerstone of all our policies, reflecting our strong conviction that deliberate government focus and action is needed to stem the tide of rising unemployment. We shall deploy and harness every resource available, especially through agribusinesses, to create jobs and put our people to work.
The empowerment programs have increased the self-worth of the youths in Delta and has made them stronger. The Youth Empowerment Scheme of Governor Okowa is in line with measures taken to substantially reduce youth unemployment via empowerment and skills training captured in Goal 8 of 2030 Sustainable Development Agenda adopted by world leaders in 2015.
His Excellency the Governor saw the future because, you know, his smart agenda came before the SDGs. What that has done is that the efforts of the present administration to touch the lives of Deltans, you know, by way of job creation, by way of teaching the youth new skills, by way of empowerment in various forms, are all geared towards uplifting the lives of the people.
Having identified the problem and a possible solution, the Senator Dr. Arthur Ifeanyi-Okowa led administration through the Job Creation Office set the ball rolling. This vision midwifed the birth of the Youth Agricultural Empowerment Program YAGEP, Skill Training Entrepreneurship Program STEP, Production Processing Support Program PPSP, Graduate Employment Enhancement Program GEEP, Tractorization, and many others.
Some of these pains that's associated with a local agriculture, subsistence agriculture, with mechanized farming, with tractorization, some of these drudgeries are overcome. And that will now encourage the youth, because if they are not using their physical power, if they observe that they can tractorize, most of the activities in the farm can be mechanized, you see that most of them will be encouraged into agriculture.
To ensure these programs worked effectively in line with his smart agenda and campaign promises, the Okowa-led administration initiated a pre-training program where beneficiaries and participants are exposed to a measure of character molding and requisite theoretical knowledge for their chosen fields of endeavor. Depending on the vocation, training could last between 3 and 6 months.
Even when they give you your certain pack and everything, you don't want to take off immediately. And don't wait, so now you can start planning. If you are going to collaborate, this is the time. Because you know some people that share your vision.
This journey has become, is very, very, very important in starting a business, because it has given us all it takes for us to start a business, for us to be a good entrepreneur.
Applicants who successfully scale through the screening are then camped at Delta Songhai Farms at Amugbe and other vocational centers scattered around the three senatorial districts of the state, where they are placed under the tutelage of seasoned business teachers and motivational speakers who teach, mentor, monitor, and prepare them for the task ahead.
A student that acquire everyday practical for a good 3 months, you'll be able to boast of doing a tangible thing. If people visit their business outlets, they will know that yes, they learned well.
With trainings over, they are given starter packs relating to their various trades and vocations to start up their business.
An accountant turned a fashion designer, you will prosper. You will not remember today and shed tears. It is a day of blessing, and this blessing is forever.
I want to say big kudos to Senator Dr. Ifeanyi-Okowa, who is the governor of Delta State, who gave this grace to we the youth that are handicapped, have nothing to do, and who empowered us. May God give him the grace to do more in this political area.
He have done more than even expected to fulfill his elections promises he have made. I can say that over 15,000 youth has been self-employed on these issues of YAGEPreneur and Stepreneur, and I'm one of the beneficiaries.
YAGEP, since inception in 2016, has consistently enriched countless lives, both in the rural and urban centers, as seen in the just concluded induction ceremony of over 745 beneficiaries, including 30 physically challenged individuals, which took place in Asaba, the state capital.
Truly urge you to stay in the realization of the fact that you stand out among the millions of youths in Nigeria, and that wherever you stand, they want to see what you'll be. Many will wish you well. Some are looking to find fault in you. We are praying that you be that role model that will positively influence
We are not involved in doing anything until we met the governor. Then he promised to come and help us, which he fulfilled. Now I am self-employed.
I won't talk of my next step. Even as for now, I have a pond. I use my monthly stipends to buy two brookshops, to ash on my own. I even thank the governor much. What he's doing is very nice.
Fish farmers like Agogo, Oyene Kewede, who injured a spinal cord during youth service but refused to be put down by her seeming travails, can pass for an ambassador of the program in her own right. She talks about her experiences and the beauty of the near future.
I will say a very big thank you to our governor, because presently this farm are about 77, which means 77 people have been lifted up the unemployment market. And I believe from here, these 70 persons will go over time to employ other people, thereby also reducing the level of unemployment in the state.
Fish farmers in Alero Cluster Farm at Egbokodo Ishakiri in Wari, Ibuzo Fish Farms and Anwai Clusters in Asaba are doing well and smiling to the banks. They too share their stories.
Before now, I was in the streets, roaming around, no help. But when I heard about this program, I applied and I got it. So I'm into it now. You can see me harvesting. It has really helped me a lot.
In our determination to know more, Smart Delta crew, with an unquenchable thirst to learn more about the impact these schemes have had on the youths as well as the economy, landed at Yeta Cluster Farms at Amugwe, where we met the radiant Miss Ebiundu Ekiariko, who is a pig farmer. With so much confidence, she lets us into her world of animal husbandry.
I actually didn't have the dream of becoming a pig farmer. But I remember when I was growing up, when they asked me, where do you want to become? I would say a farmer. And my daddy was like, how can you be saying you want to be a farmer? Say something else. So this opportunity has actually made my dream while I was a child to come true. With this, so I would say kudos to the government for giving this opportunity.
She wasn't alone, as Ugbara Urubogene, who farms at Otoyede Cluster Farms, adds his voice to the story.
I want to thank our able governor, Okowa, for having put this program in place. I can boldly say I'm an entrepreneur, and I've seen the agro-business in terms of livestock. By the grace of God, it has really impacted on my life.
Poultry farmers were equally not left out of their goodies. Beneficiaries in Ibuzo, ADP Cluster Farms, Mbiri Clusters and elsewhere also narrate their achievements thus far.
I'm a graduate of mechanical engineering. For about 4 years, I've been in the streets, hoping that one day fortune will smile on me until our governor big interest on the youth and bring out this program that you want to take youth out of the street. So this program has really helped me. Today I have my own mobility. I have my own flat I'm staying. my business has been flourishing.
Those into crop farming like tomatoes, rice, cassava, maize and cucumber are not left out. At Ewulo Cluster Farms, we met Emeka mining his farm and staking tomato stalks.
The truth is that the species of these tomatoes is of high quality because every of the persons or the customers have taken it to, they appreciated it and they never expected that such could come from this our side.
A further trip to Songhai Farms, Amukwe, Smart Delta Media team met young entrepreneurs on their farms harvesting their produce. They told us what they have been able to achieve thus far and are happy that they have been able to put into good use the starter parks given to them by the state government.
Agriculture is the future of our nation. We want to be partakers. We want to be the vanguard, the people driving this growth.
Smart Delta. Having reviewed the strength, weaknesses, as well as successes recorded so far on the YAGEP program, the government resolved to use the community-based module going forward, that is, communities with comparative advantage in a particular produce are being encouraged to maximize such potentials.
It means that you take into cognizance the peculiarities of all of the communities where that exists in your area and begin to grow those jobs in those environments and empower those human beings.
The Alero Fish Farm Cluster at Egbokodo Ishekiri in Wari and Ugbokodo Fish Farm in Nokbe are classical examples of this module. They have the natural swampy terrain suitable for the development of fish ponds. Such natural setting enhances fish farming as fishes grow faster in their natural habitat.
They gave me 2,000 fingerling to start my own. And as I speak with you now, my fish, they are doing well. And with this, Governor Okowa is coming again to come and empower the youth of Delta State. Because from here, I'm going to go greater. The world will see my fish.
Government has equally taken advantage of the good soil type that abound in the state to maximize the production of both rice and cassava.
Before the selection of this particular site, a team was sent to collect samples and they did soil analysis. After the analysis, the results showed that this place has a high nutrient capacity and the land here is contiguous. So that informed the establishment of this cluster here.
I was here last month, really. Then they just did their planting, weed control, and a kind of fertilization. About a month later, I came in to check the growth rate of the farm, and I was marveled at the way I saw things.
Welcome to Delta. My Delta, my Delta. Welcome to Delta. My Delta, my Delta. Come live in Delta. Come invest in Delta. Come explore the potentials of our state. You better run, run, come. Come to Delta State. Come and see the good things where Okowa he they do. You better run, come. Come to Delta State. Come and see the good things where Okowa he they do. I see a job and wealth creation in Delta. Make the youth say them highla Okowa.
Skills Training Entrepreneurship Program STEP is yet another empowerment module through which the Okowa-led administration is creating jobs and building confidence and self-worth in the ever-creative youths of Delta. The STEP module focuses on practical application of skills to master a particular trade or craft.
This empowerment from our able governor, Dr. Senator Ifeanyi Okowa, is the best because in other previous empowerment, they would just copy name and give them money and that's all. But this very one, you are asked to go to the training. Those people that know what they went there for, they are benefiting from it. And almost everybody that went for the training was fully empowered. I want to commend Governor for that.
It's a very laudable program, and so many youths are enjoying it. You could see the excitement. They were very happy to display what they had learned and what they now produce. And some of them were so happy to say, oh, and I employ five people.
Delta State Shoe and Leather Factory at Iseluku was set up to train youths on skills in leather works and traditional fabric called akwacha.
I don't think I have any other word for the governor than to say thank you, because ever before now there has been youth restiveness in the state. But since inception in 2015 that he came into office, there has been positive changes in the lives of every youth, and I'm grateful for the governor. He is the best governor I've ever seen in the state.
Today, we have the likes of Omar, who is another beneficiary of the STEP program. She is into makeovers and events management. Just like Omar, we have other persons like Sophie, the CEO of Sophina Beauty Parlor. She is also doing well in makeovers. She is a proud business owner and also a trainer, all thanks to skills she learned from STEP.
I'm a beneficiary of the Skills Training and Entrepreneurship Program, STEP. As you can see right now, I have 12 girls that I'm training. They're actually learning now, and I've been able to graduate 12.
The governor may not be able to train everybody, but for him training one person, that one person will train like 50 people. Like me, Sophina, he has trained me, but now less than 2 years, I've trained almost 50 people.
Countless others are into fashion and designing and CEOs in their own companies.
I have a dream of having a fashion school. I want to train people. The government has trained me, and by the grace of God, I have the capability to impact on them also.
Mrs. Helen Obiageli is the owner of Bounty Impex Fashion House in Asaba and a STEP trainer on fashion and designs. She lauded government's initiative on empowerment, explaining that the program would aid in no small measure to take youths off the street.
Looking at the situation of unemployment in this country, he said, I'm going to create jobs. More than 20-something persons passed through my establishment. They have all opened up their businesses. So he has given them the platform to become what they want to become. I want to say I am very grateful. His promise he has fulfilled, and we can see it.
Audio visuals and ICT was next on our card. Our quest for facts landed us at Upper Williams Schoolville Training Center. Trainings here are multifaceted, as trainees are grilled in movie production, cinematography, ENG editing, video shooting, and more. Trainees in the center gave the smart governor a thumbs up for the chance he has given them to better their lives.
The journey has been wonderful. I really appreciate the governor, Ifeanyi Okorah, for this wonderful opportunity. Really appreciate it, and we promise not to disappoint. I promise to support him in our own very way to help eradicating this unemployment.
The pursuit of facts essentially to get first-hand information from beneficiaries on how the empowerment schemes impacted their lives further landed smart crew in other vocational centers in the state.
I have to say a big, big thank you to our governor, Dr. Okorah, for his great work, favor that he has given to me. Among the crowd, I'm shortlisted. I appreciate him for that.
On assumption of office, he created a job creation office. He did not stop at that. He went ahead to create an enabling environment to enable the MDA succeed. I can say from what was seen that the job creation effort of the state is a big success.
We had a chat with those in vocational skills such as barbing, catering, electrical installation, and hairdressing. Also, those into baking and confectionaries are not left out.
Since I finished my 1 month refresher and they gave me my starter pack, things has been so good. At least I can eat 3 square meals a day, and I so much thank God for what our daddy Okorah has done in our life, and we said may God continue to bless him.
From the Asaba axis, we moved to Abraka, where we met trainees who are into welding and fabrication. They applauded the governor Ifeanyi Okorah-led administration for his life-changing policies, which is transforming the lives of young Deltans today.
With the knowledge we have here, what we establish on our own, at least we use the idea to forward. Especially me, I want to be more than Moga so that you can see me as a proud apprentice.
Our next port of call landed us at AY Touch Studio and Events Management in Sapele. The instructor, Mrs. Vera Justice, said she couldn't have been more proud of her students as they have been very receptive to her teaching method.
All of them are very willing, and since they came, have not had any issue with any of them. They are very good at it, and most of them they even do at home.
Trainees under Mrs. Vera Justice are grateful to government for providing them the platform to learn a trade that will give them a better life. They added that they would also extend their acquired knowledge to others.
After getting my starter pack, I'll be my own boss, and I'll have my own workers under me, train other people.
Maybe to be self-reliant, I'll not be dependent on somebody. I hope to fend for myself, my family, when the time comes. Governor, I really try though.
For 2018-2019 cycle, after a critical evaluation and appraisal, government decided to make it better by taking empowerment a step closer to the people in distant villages like in the creeks.
It may interest you to note that Ogbokodo Okpe cluster and Ogbokodo Shekiri cluster, we had 124 ponds and we improved it with 52 ponds this year. Now these two clusters, they were abandoned creeks, wastelands. Today these wastelands are producing wealth for the youth.
To ensure no one is left behind in the youth empowerment program of the Okoa-led administration, in line with its campaign promises, a more embracing step has been taken in the 2018-2019 cycle. Selection, which was principally done from Asaba, will now be domiciled in the local government areas, ensuring the benefits get to the grassroots.
I'm also from the grassroots, all the way from the riverine area. I've not been part of government. If you touch my life also, you have touched others, because if I'm employed today, I'm going to employ others under the village.
Yes, it will help me to feed my family, my people around me. It's very good.
For this cycle, government has embraced brown step trainees, that is, those who on their own acquired skills but lack the resources they need to start up their businesses. Screening exercises have been concluded, and some participants who spoke with us expressed their confidence and trust in the process, which they described as credible.
I like the way everywhere is orderly and everything just going smooth.
Even the youth were happy, because it's not easy to government to remember the youth to empower. I'm very, very happy.
Other beneficiaries gave a further insight about the exercise.
I would really appreciate it if it would go a long way to help me remove myself from a liability or begging in the street.
Ayokoa for empowerment will do for the Delta State.
To avoid the many pitfalls associated with startups, the Delta State Government, through one of her agencies, Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises Development Agency, has put machinery in place for beneficiaries to gain access to soft loans to enable them stand. This has been further extended to women groups, cooperative societies and other artisans to further energize the economic base of the state. Another empowerment program the government has embarked on is the Widow's Empowerment Scheme, where each widow is given a monthly stipend. The scheme has also enrolled the women in the Contributory Health Insurance Scheme and paid up their premium.
Okoa, they work with a senior. No governor like Okoa. Nobody don't do this kind of thing before when they do for we. This election, when they come for 2019, nobody go fit challenge Okoa. No Okoa now go come again, so that our money go they go on.
I'm more than grateful as I'm here. Even though I'm not among the widows, but I'm a world woman leader. But what our governor, Excellency, Okoa, they do for this state, we never see the time before.
The success story of the Job and Wealth Creation Program of the Okoa-led administration found a fertile ground in the heart of Tony Elumelu, founder of Tony Elumelu Foundation. The foundation, which is in the forefront of supporting young African entrepreneurs on account of the life-changing testimonies, supported the Delta State Government with 500 million naira.
It makes me more proud of my state of origin, and it makes me happier to call this excellent Dr. Okoa my governor.
Beyond the empowerment programs, the government has embarked on infrastructure developments that have provided employment for Deltans, cutting across age and gender.
If not for this work, I think I'll still be at home doing nothing. I want to say a big thank you to Okua, the governor, who has been able to put in much to make sure that the youths in Delta State are being employed through such projects.
We thank God for the project. The government has really tried for us, for making us to live the amnesty level and for making us to live a better life.
Like some women say, they don't get work to do. Through this rice farm, we get many work to do.
Promises made, promises fulfilled. The government and the good people of Delta State can only look forward to better days ahead under the watch of Senator Dr. Arthur Ifeanyi Okowa.
Come and see the good things where Okowa he dey do, he better run, come to Delta State. Come and see the good things where Okowa he dey do. I see a job and wealth creation in Delta, make the youth say them highlight.
Okowa,
I see good roads everywhere in Delta, make the people say them cola. Ekweme, come live in Delta.
Say me I say,
come invest in Delta. Come explore the potentials of our state.